guys, welcome to The Couch with me, Oyebola, Olubunmi. Today I have an important guest. He is the man behind some hit songs that we all know, the likes of Madu by Kizz Daniel or Ima DJ Spino featuring Mr. Easy. You know, please make welcome Tunde Ayotunde Lawa, aka Lussh Beatz. How are you doing? It's so good to have you on my couch today.
Thank you.
So we'll be having conversations, we'll be gisting.
You know? I know, I like gisting.
You know, let's talk about you being a producer now.
Yeah.
You've done a couple of songs that we like, that we love. I personally, I love Oyema.
For real?
Yeah, I still vibed to you this afternoon before you came in. I'm telling you. It's like jam, back to back, any day, any time. So let's talk about how it started for you. How did it start?
I think the story is cliche, you know, everybody, church. So me, it was church. But I think it was school first, primary school. You know, this boy band always attend the table. Your classmate rapping, just too bad. Then I think so my aunt was the worker at church. So she drags me. I'm like, yo, let's go to church, So I go to church like 3 times a week.
Wow.
I go to church Thursday,
wow.
Wednesday, Saturday and Sunday. So, you know, I was always, I just found myself in the midst of music. Like when there's praise and worship, I'm hyped, you know. But when it's time for dozing and sleeping. So I think I just found myself around music. And before, you know, I started playing the conga drums in church, children's church.
So I play drums to date,
you know. So I, from conga drums, then I think I was like 13, then I moved to the youth church, then I started learning the drum set itself properly. Then from there, I think I got quick, I learned the drum set fast, so I could play in the middle of the drum at church. So I think that's where all those music components, musical ingredients and stuff installed in me. I was just hearing the keyboard, bass, guitar, the drums, the conga, everything. Then before you know, I started singing too.
Wow. So you sing?
I'm like, I sing for me.
Nice. You'll be doing that, I'm not sure.
No, I won't.
You will.
I don't plan to be an artist, so I don't sing. I sing for business. I mean, I sing a song as a reference. So when I want to sell, when I want to send to an artist, yeah, and that's something. It's not like I sing. So yeah, okay. Yeah.
But we'd still like to have a few of that, just a little tiny bit.
I can't promise.
Okay, so you've worked with several artists, you know, likes of Kizz Daniel, Mayokun, Peruzzi, and all. When Oyema came out and was a banger, like everybody was vibing to it, how did you feel?
Two ways. I felt good, you know, that was okay. Because, fun fact, Oyema was like my official single, like the single that kicked off Lussh as a music producer. And it was super big. So, from there, I just knew, okay, there's a purpose for this, you know. So, I started chasing it. But, Oyema was big. I saw people vibing, people outside the country, vibing, doing stuff. But I wasn't getting enough recognition from the industry, so that's like the other side of it. I enjoyed, I was happy that Oyema was out there, everybody was happy listening to it, some was deep. But then I expected a push or a lift for myself. But I think looking back and now, I think what Oyema just did for me was set the
table.
That's it. And so I don't regret anything. I appreciate DJ Spino and Mr. Easy being on that jam, you know. And it's a big deal for me, because every time now that I say, what song did you produce? And I like say, Oyema, everybody's like, wow. So I'm like, okay, so the song is still has its effect now.
Of course, just like it's having its effect on me, you know. Yeah, so now let's talk about you. you recently worked with Young John, the Wicked producer.
Yeah.
How was it for you collaborating to work on Mayakun's song?
So before Young John co-produced, before we worked together on Mayakun's song,
mm-hmm.
I met with him. I think he just, I've been a big fan. So I just saw him mention one day, and it was Young John. He's like my favorite producers right now. Lussh Beatz, Cracker, and Rexy. I'm like, wow. So I just messed up like Jiggy, thanks man, I'm a big fan. He's like, yo, I'm a big fan, man. Come to us, sit down in the studio, talk to him.
So you reached out to him after he mentioned.
Yeah, I mean, come on. That's,
right.
That's respect, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I have big respect for him. So I just, so we got a day, fixed a day, got to rent his house. You know, we had talks. That's what I always like to do with producers. I like to talk to them. Aside from opening the laptop and learning from, which like that's like the last thing on my mind. What I want to do is enough experience, knowledge. I like to learn like things about life, like how people grow up and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I spoke to them during, or we were speaking, and it just made some things clear to me, or clearer. It was clear, but him talking to me made it clearer to me, and he was like, okay, yeah, so you need to work on his song. I'm like, ah, yes, now we'll do it. But then I played him some beat, and I was like, hey, crazy, he played me some, I think that's when I heard his song, Hello Baby, with Kizz Daniel and Teni. He played me some beat, and I was like, ah,
true.
This is my, like, yeah, it's dropping, I'm like, ah, this is fire,
that's
like,
a jam, and it's still a jam right now.
Big jam, millions of views on YouTube, you know. So, coincidentally, just called out, Young John's gonna be my record. I'm like, for real, yeah, man, get you done. And I think after Young John finished, you know, he sent me a message like, bro, that song is fire. How did you know that?
I
follow you, you know, I follow your footsteps. I'm like, oh, cool. And that's how we just, so before we even did the song, we really linked up and had the idea of the agreement to say we'll collaborate on something together.
Mm-hmm.
So it was easy peasy, and to date, come on, we're still cool, good. Sometimes I go to this place, you know, to watching work and learn some stuff. Yeah.
Wow, and so we've seen you work with Young John,
yeah.
And it was pretty amazing.
Yeah.
It was interesting to see you work with that and coming out with that kind of song.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So which other producers would you love to work with in the industry?
I love to work with Sarz, Peruzzi, and the craft, you know. Peruzzi is a close person to me. At some point in our lives, we used to live on the same roof.
Wow.
I learned from him, he learned from me. We've been on records together, but they're not out yet. Yeah, those three stars are going to be a great opportunity for me. Mastercraft, greatest opportunity for me, yeah.
Wow, you just shot your shot. More like, you know.
Actually, yes, sir. Yes,
exactly.
Mastercraft.
Shooting shots, so just did that now. Alright, so we've heard producers say they've been working on a particular beat for years, some months. What was the shortest time you've had to work on a particular beat?
Shortest?
Yes.
Think of
an hour. Really?
Fun fact, right now, man, it's not like I'm blowing my trumpet, but yeah, let me blow my trumpet. I think 2 weeks ago, I made 3 beats in like 2 hours.
Wow.
And trust me, if I play the beats for you, you'd be wild. Because the thing is, I try to work with my head. So I create in my head. If I connect the dots properly, I get to the studio, turn on my computer, and get all my instruments. So when I create my, to the very little part, I create everything here. So when I on my computer, what my hands are just doing what my head has processed. So it's easier, it's faster.
Okay, especially when you have the right
equipment.
Yeah,
bam, do and done, export, do this, sound it properly, export, do the last one, you know, cool, export.
Okay, so
sometimes I can be like a month, 2 months, 3 months on the beat,
mm-hmm.
because I don't have an idea.
Okay.
But most times what I've found is if it takes that long, accrues it, exports it, sends it to another producer. Because I like collaboration instead of competition. Competition is gonna work if it's healthy. But I won't lie to competition right now in the music industry is unhealthy. Trust me. Competition is unhealthy because the thing, you don't even look at the positive side, look at the negative side, that's it. So competition is a no no for me. Collaboration is like 100 for me. So I prefer to collaborate. You know.
Wow. Okay, so speaking of getting beats done like ASAP and all that, that means you have the right equipment and all. So what is the best software right now or the major software that you use?
Well, like my own best software, I don't care what anybody says, is FL. Fruity Loops, like it's the best because I can manipulate, I can do anything I want to do on Fruity Loops.
So let's talk about your songwriting part. You write songs.
Yes, I do.
And you give it out to artists. Yeah. And do we have anyone out there
Trust me, you don't even know. You don't just have an idea that I did that because it was there. But I co-wrote Bobo.
Wow.
So me, I produced it. Killer to go produce. And I co-wrote it. It was an idea I recorded it, sent it to Malcolm. He listened to it, liked it. He put his own words, his own writing skills to me, and get it. Then that's it. I co-wrote enough for it, that's it. It's just a particular part, it wasn't too big, just the other side of the chorus.
I love the song.
Yeah, plenty. There are songs out there now that. So where I work on if you're not 100% very 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 good, extremely good in writing, when you pay for session or stuff, I include writing. So I voluntarily write and record backups. Like that's the added plus when you work with Luush.
That's beautiful. That's nice.
See,
you know,
the thing is, I take music production as like a 9-to-5 job. You know, when you meet, I don't want to mention his name, I met a big CEO. He said he leaves his house for 100k, for 100k profit. He says he has up to $1 billion. Because it's 100k doesn't mean you should just slide it through. So what I'm just saying is, it's production, yes, but just make it proper, add spices to make sure that the clients are satisfied.
Utility is very important.
You know, one thing music producers do, or entertainers, they know how to waste time. And I think it's uncalled for, it's unnecessary. Don't waste your client's time. Do the thing you're supposed to do on time, and let it go. The way it even works for me, if I do what I'm supposed to do, and let it go, it's better, the waste is less, you know. Instead of, I know I'm doing this, it adds up, and at the end of the day, you're confused, and you have impression about you. You create a bad impression about yourself. So I just discipline myself and add that to my.
Okay, speaking of producers and artists, you know, when a song comes out, the people tend to praise the artist the more, not knowing that the producer too also has something to contribute to it. How do you feel that producers are not really celebrated in the music industry?
So the thing is, it's not really our fault. So it wasn't, I shouldn't say it's our fault. My own is, so it was not a culture before. So from the onset, from the beginning, let's even take our Afrobeat. Or let's put it Afrobeat. Listen to the sounds, listen to Fela's. In Fela's song, like 15 minutes is instrumental. Do you know the keyboardist? Do you know the drummer? Do you know who plays the paint counter? Do you know who plays the paint? You don't. But who do you know? Fela. So the culture is, the person you are listening to, your voice, the person you are seeing. So that's we're used to that, you know. So right now it's changing. I'm here. I'm sure you have another producer, or you're having another producer. So right now,
sorry to come out.
Yeah, we have to let people know. See, I think we wouldn't even come out if there was a structure for people behind this thing. Mm-hmm. There was a structure for people behind this thing. I'm not sure how it came, because I know that once I produce a song, I know that, okay, there's a structure. I know that, oh, this is coming here, this is going here, this is it. But because there's a structure, I have to do it myself. And other people are doing it themselves too. So I think it was not a culture before, but now producers are beginning to, not even just producers, writers, DOPs.
Yeah, so many people. Yeah,
yeah, the things, yeah,
yes,
they're coming out.
True.
So that's great.
Mm-hmm. So now let's talk, speaking of artists and producers, which artist in the industry would you love to work with right now?
I want to work with Bonner. I want to work with David and this kid. Okay, I think that's three of them. Bonner, David, and this kid. I probably want to work with some other people, but I can't wrap them up
right now.
And I need to, not I even,
need
I
to
need
with,
to work with Bonner, David,
and
this kid.
Why do you see the future of live production, because we have so many softwares out there right now that's taking over live productions.
It has a large space. Live production still has a large space because originality still wants to sell. Some people still want to. There are some songs that you cannot
use the software for.
A few so. There are some songs. No matter how bad you want to produce your jazz music, no matter how you want to use a software to produce jazz music, you still need some live bar or something. Except, yeah, I feel that just no matter how live music will still stay, it has a space, it will still flourish.
It's still flourish. Okay, so now let's talk about your recent release.
Mm-hmm.
That your song with Peruzzi.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's becoming a vibe. It's not out yet, right? But wow.
It's actually out there. It was out on Monday.
On Monday, yeah, yeah. True. Because I heard it and I thought it wasn't punched out yet.
Yeah.
That song, how long did it take you to work on it? And, you know, it's such a vibe.
Big vibe, but you know, so I say less is more. You know,
true.
Because it didn't take me, I won't lie, it didn't take me long, it didn't take me, like, it wasn't too much weight on me when I was producing the song. It was just one of those days where I wanted to feel different, not produce the normal. I just wanted to add some PKO notes from different genres. So I picked from R&B, I picked from reggae, then, because I know that, yeah, this is where this is the market I'm appealing to, so I added my drums, I made my drums, some Afrobeat. So it wasn't easy. If I showed you the project of the song, there's a little bit, you understand?
Wow.
And Peruzzi made it more easier when we got to recording. So the first time we heard the song, it was one of those days I was shooting my video. So I dropped a song, the reading, how are you? And I shot the video. So the video was just a lifestyle video. Going to different people's houses, and so I think I was about leaving the island and I called him. I was like, yeah, come down to the house, and I went to the house. And after I played my song for him, the Aoi, and he was like, oh, this is my, just make sure DJs play. I was like, cool, then. He just made a statement that I should be hiding those heavy beats.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, ah, come on, man. Then I played him. I'm like, okay, I'd not expected it for FL, I just didn't have the project. So I clicked on FL, okay, and then I played for him. He just said, it wasn't up to like 10 seconds, like, yo, my album straight. I'm like, okay, my number. Then it was freestyling.
To the beats, right?
Yeah, to the beats, it was freestyling. What kept on coming to his mouth? Nah, 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 nah. That was like constant. You said a lot of things as you go back to but eventually when we had to record, it was like a week later.
Wow.
And we recorded, and I even played in the video that, well, what's your freestyle that day actually made sense? So like, no, don't pick. That's just only pick Nana. So we just picked only Nana and the melody. And you wrote
something different.
Peruzzi is one of the, if not, the best songwriters we have.
Mm-hmm. I was just going to say that.
We have in the country, or in Africa.
And his lyrics are usually very tight.
So one thing about Peruzzi that people really love, for Peruzzi to freestyle, it makes a whole lot of sense.
Wow.
I've been an artist and a freestyler, and just like, okay. And you know that, oh, when you shuffle it here and there, then sit down to write.
Mm-hmm.
But when Peruzzi is freestyling, you have like, it's a song word.
Awesome.
So if we start, for really freestyle, you didn't write, if we start, you and I, Bonnie and Clyde, my number one baby, my really not baby.
Wow.
He actually freestyled.
Peruzzi, we need you in the studio.
Do you understand?
We need you to go freestyle.
Fam, this is a freestyle and this is so sweet and super extraordinary, whatever, you know. So, and it was easy for him. Papa, we recorded the full song. He went on live, Instagram live, he was listening like, oh, this is crazy. I think a week later or so, yeah, about a week, he just texted me on WhatsApp. I was like, yo, mix and master the song, the medication. I'm like, ah, for real, what's happening? Then he sent me the video that casted the song, the activated session. Big shout out to Amazing, Amazing Club. So he showed me the video, I was like, I dropped in this video online, and I think the next day, oh. And he says, sees in his words, he says, he said, when we drop it, we wait for 3 days.
Okay.
Or definitely before we release. But then when he dropped the email, the next day, I saw my friend send me a video in a car playing the song. I was like, so Alpha, how did you get it? It's everywhere. Like, how do you mean it's everywhere?
Oh, you've not released it yet?
The song. The song is being released. Like, I was like, it's everywhere. Then, Peruzzi, I think it was outside Lagos. That I called you. I was like, oh, you call me when it gets to Lagos. When it gets to Lagos, I just told you, oh, man, the song
is everywhere.
So, well, that song is stuff. You did not even expect that. The song wasn't even trending on Twitter already. I was like, wow, this is big, big for me. Officially released the song on Monday.
Yeah.
Actually, if you listen to the release version, if you are that music person, you fall in love with it more than the one that came out. Because when it was about to release, I did a few Lussh Magic, you know, which is a bump for me. I went for mix and master and released. So great, great big vibe of the
week. Yeah, it's a vibe actually. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're going to switch things up right now.
Okay.
We're going to do something fun.
Right.
So this segment of the show actually gives people an idea. It gives people an idea of your personality.
Okay.
More like, you know, kind of personality that you are. Okay, so it's called the this and that segment.
Okay. So it's like, I'm saying this, I'm saying that.
More like to choose one over the other.
Okay, that's cool.
Yeah. Alright. So we have money or true love.
Money or what?
Money or true love.
True love.
True love. Okay. So we have iPhone or Android.
Android.
So you're an Android user.
Yeah.
Wow. What's together? This ministry. Keyboard or boobs.
Sorry?
Keyboard or boobs.
Keyboard.
Keyboard.
Or boobs.
You have 3 seconds.
3 seconds. Keyboard or boobs on keyboard.
Okay, mainland or island?
Mainland.
Kizz Daniel or Danny V?
Kizz Daniel.
Club or movies?
Movies.
So
movies
the,
not in the cinema. I don't know
the
cinema.
So you're the indoor type?
Yeah, very, very indoor.
Wow.
So indoor.
Reserved or outspoken?
Reserved.
I think that's. Foreplay or straight to action?
Foreplay. Never even go to action. So.
Foreplay. Like, you have to dwell on it.
Foreplay, I'm not even going to do action.
Okay, so Bentley or Beamer?
Bentley.
So, this part, you kiss, marry, or jail one person?
Okay.
You jail one person, kiss one person, or you marry one person? We are Seyi Shay, Yemi Alade, Victoria Kimani.
Jail Kimani. Kiss Mimi Manche.
Mari Shenche. Wow, interesting. Buka or Chinese?
Buka.
So you're the Luka, you know.
See, I don't like to see this thing is also like Buka, leave it. I don't know the Chinese. Anybody wants to buy the Chinese, I'm down for it, but Buka.
Okay, thank you very much for coming on the show. This is where we draw the curtains. One last word for you.
Fans, you know, people. Please, whoever is listening, whoever is watching, please be true to yourself. That's the only thing I can tell you. If you're true to yourself, greatness lies in being expert.
And less is more. Less is more.
Yeah.
Alright, thank you very much for joining us on this episode of The Couch till we come your way again. But before then, follow us on all our social media platforms at Unsigned Africa and on our YouTube channel, Unsigned Africa TV. Please like, share, comment, and follow.